It's fairly compact, not that it's really a big deal for me, just because of the size of my case. And right now I currently have an EVGA 2070 Super running, and I've had that for a few months with the whole idea, I guess, to, if I could get my hands on a 3070 or 3080, I would go ahead and do that. But as far as I know, the 3070s are a little bit easier to get than the 3080s, but that's besides the point. So, yeah. So we'll just go through the overview and the specs here. Again, this is on just Zotac's website. So I'll go over this stuff. Memory, the Zotac Zotac, and it is VR ready. So, it says here, get amplified. So this is the NVIDIA Ampere architecture. So it has the ray tracing. Processing tensor cores on GeForce RTX. This gives you the performance headroom to crank up settings and resolutions for an incredible visual experience. The AI revolution has arrived to gaming. So it's got the white LED logo. In my case, even though it isn't white, I do have Super that I have from EVGA. It is the black version, so that just means it doesn't have any RGB in it, which I could really care less about if my card has RGB on it, so I think this is kind of a nice touch to be able to have the white on it, but not have anything super, super crazy, you know, in your face, so. As I showed there, so it's got GeForce RTX, the Zotac logo, and Live to Game. So it says bring down the Mercury Advanced Cooling, and this is going over their Ice Storm 2.0, a more refined Ice Storm 2.0 cooling system is purpose built. Six.